Hello everyone, I am Manali Reshamwala, Assistant Professor from LJ Institute of Physiotherapy. Today I am going to talk about physiotherapy assessment and management in detail about pleural effusion. It is a part of syllabus for final year physiotherapy students of Gujarat University, and the subject is physiotherapy in cardiopulmonary conditions. So let's see first the definition. This is an accumulation of fluid in the pleural cavity. If we see the pathology, we may find either a transudate type of fluid inside the cavity or exudate. Transudate is usually of low protein, which is having less than 35 gram per liter protein in that fluid, or exudate, which has high protein, more than 35 gram per liter. They both have different etiology, so we can see in physiotherapy assessment, general assessment, we will take the demographic data. Then history, maybe following unresolved dry pleurisy, or secondary to, if there is an exudate type of fluid, we may find these are all the etiological factors, which are congestive cardiac failure or nephrotic syndrome or cirrhosis of liver. An exudate type of pleural effusion is because of malignancy of lungs or pulmonary infarction, pneumonia, tuberculosis, or collagen disease like rheumatoid arthritis or systemic lupus erythrosis. So let's see the subjective assessment in physiotherapy assessment, which is includes breathlessness, cough, chest pain, sputum, hemoptysis, etc. So let's see the breathlessness, which is present in case of large effusion due to pressure of the fluid reduces lung expansion. We need to ask duration, severity and pattern directly to the patient itself. Next is cough. Patient may have complaint of hacking cough and chest pain, pleuritic chest pain less than the dry pleurisy. Dry pleurisy is just inflammation of pleura. Next is objective assessment, which will include an observation, general observation. First, level of consciousness. Usually these kind of patients are conscious. General health and body build. Patient may have pyrexia, night sweats, lethargy, shaking chills, etc. Cyanosis is present with a large effusion only. On observation of chest, we may find chest shape normal, but chest wall movement is reduced or absent on the side affected, and use of accessory muscle is also present. On palpation, we may find chest wall expansion, there is asymmetrical movement, especially reduced on the affected side. Then vocal fremitus, which is reduced over the area of the fluid, and position of trachea or mediastinum is shifted towards opposite side if there is a large pleural effusion. On percussion, we may find dull note on the area of pleural effusion. On examination vital sign, we may find tachycardia, tachypnea, pulse are usually quick and rapid, temperature is also high. And on chest expansion, we have to measure it at the 3 level during inspiration and expiration. On auscultation, on breath sound, we may find absent or bronchial breath sound above the level of effusion. Vocal resonance is usually reduced or absent. Possible whispered pectoral echo at the upper level of the effusion. Heart sound, usually S1 and S2 are present. Range of motion of shoulder and thoracic spine reduces gradually. And exercise tolerance test, if we take 6-minute walk test of a patient, we may find reduced tolerance of patient. On investigation in chest X-ray, we may find fluid level. On lateral view, effusion causes lower vertebral bodies to appear greater in the density, and large effusion may show mediastinal displacement. So let's see an X-ray of pleural effusion. Here we can see patient is having pleural effusion on the left lung. A lower area we can see a fluid level. If we are seeing it in a PA view, we can also find out whether there is a shift of trachea or mediastinum is there or not. As this is a small effusion, there is no medial shift we can see. But on the lateral view, we can see vertebral body is very clear. That means because of pleural effusion, we are seeing it's in a greater density, especially the lower thoracic vertebrae. And we can also mark a fluid level on the lateral aspect. So we can see that there is no costophrenic angle on left side. Another diagnosis is diagnostic aspiration of fluid. In a case of pleural effusion, medical management may include aspiration of the fluid, and if we are sending that aspirated fluid to laboratories, we may find that if there is pleural effusion plus neoplasm, then we may find blood stained fluid. So if there is a blood stained fluid in the pleura after aspiration, that we may suspect some of the neoplasms in it. So let's see the management. First, we will see about the medical management. The aim of treatment is to achieve resolution of pleural effusion without a residual fibrosis. So most of the pleural effusion, what happens, the area where the lung expansion is not being able to do properly, the fibrosis may develop, especially in the visceral pleura. Because of that, that area expansion is not even there even after resolution of the pleural effusion. So we need to prevent it with medical as well as physiotherapy management. So medical treatment is of underlying disease or drainage of the effusion, either by aspiration through a needle or a three-way tip, or by inserting a chest drain linked into an underwater sill. So that is underwater drainage tube. Aspiration for massive pleural effusion, not more than 500 to 1000 ml per session should be done. For a thick unresolving pleural effusion, we may also have some of the surgical options like pleurodesis or pleurectomy may be done, which is required in malignant pleural effusion. Oxygen therapy and physiotherapy should also be done along with these medical management. So let's see about physiotherapy management. The aims for physiotherapy management are to assist the absorption of fluid, to prevent the formation of disabling adhesions between the two layers of the pleura, to achieve full expansion of the affected lung, to increase ventilation, especially in the affected side of the lung, and to maintain increased range of motion of the thorax. So physiotherapy treatment will depend on which type of medical treatment has been taken care for a patient. If there is a aspiration is being taken, then following aspiration we can give breathing exercises to encourage the localized expansion on the affected side. We can also use belt exercise. With the help of belt, we can give compression during the inspiration and assistance during the expiration. We can also make the patient to lie down on the affected side over a firm pillow, which helps to stretch the affected side and also helps to improve the localized expansion of the lungs. So we have to keep a pile of pillows and on the side of affected. Suppose we have seen the x-ray of left side affected person, then we'll keep a pillow and we'll ask the patient to lie down on the left side only over the pillow. So it will stretch the that side, as well as it will also improve the localized lung expansion. Then it should be performed several times a day, then only it has good effect. Thoracic mobility exercise, shoulder girdle exercise and postural correction exercise should also be incorporated, which we have seen in many video tutorials before, as well as in respiratory rehabilitation. So that can be followed. And last is following pleurodesis or pleurectomy. If person has undergone for any kind of surgical procedure like this, then physiotherapy should be followed just like a treatment following thoracotomy or operations on the pleura, which we have already discussed before in my video tutorial called Physiotherapy Treatment After Lung Surgeries. So here are the references for pleural effusion, physiotherapy assessment and management. Thank you for watching.